Kitale town was almost brought to a standstill by a procession of the newly formed Ecumenical Catholic Church, a breakaway group of the Catholic Church. All this to ordain its leader. And when the procession reached its destination, it was greeted by passionate followers. Among those present were Bishop Shiundu's wife Stella Nangila and the Ecumenical Church founder Carly Raymond Roddick. And after several rituals, Father Shiundu was then officially ordained as a bishop at around 2 p.m.
Bishop Godfrey, take this stuff as a sign of your pastoral office.
Also to be ordained was Bishop Benedict Simiu.
Two new bishops for all the people of Kenya, Bishop Godfrey and Bishop Kennedy, Benedict.
The church's founder used the occasion to call for unity.
The church's formal ordination of Father Shiundu to a bishop and its Kenyan leader might elicit some reactions, some negative, some positive. The question, however, is how far this might go in setting a precedent of creating more splinter groups, driven people's desires to accommodate their own preferences in the church.
It's a question I put to Bishop Shiundu himself.
I don't care, I don't know whether this is in conformity with the Vatican, but this is in conformity with the will of God.
The bishop also expressed his acrimony with the Catholic Church.
Whether we like it or not, the change is here. It has come. Celibacy, and generally the change of the canon law in the Catholic Church.
At the Kitale showdown, there were mixed reactions over the matter.
Ile hali ya kwa upadri ni sakramenti takatifu sana ambayo mtu mwenyewe anajitolea kutoka kwa roho yake mwenyewe. Hakuna mtu anamlazimisha. Sasa ikiwa utaenda ukalafu tena uamue tena uoe, ni makosa.
Kanisa tunaliamini kwa sababu msingi wake ni imani ya Kikristo na lina it considers Holy Spirit as the basis of the church.
For Bishop Shiundu and the Ecumenical Church, they can only hope their move augurs well with Kenyans. Hussein Mohammed, Citizen TV.